The inverse of the conditional statement of the form P implies Q. Well, if you want to get the inverse of a conditional statement of this format, where P is my hypothesis, Q is a conclusion, what you do is you have to do the negation of each one. So recall that the negation, we set it up with that symbol. So if I want to do the negation of P, then that's how I would write it. And if I want to do the negation of Q, that's how I'd write it. Some textbooks may also use this symbol for the negation. So it looks like that symbol, like that, like a segment, and it goes down a little bit. So these are alternate ways, but we're going to work on it with this way. So if I want to do the negation of this conditional statement, all I have to do is do the negation of each one. So the negation of this hypothesis P would be the negation of P, or we say not P implies the negation of Q, which would be not Q. So this is the inverse. Whatever your conditional statement is, you do the negation of each one. And this is the symbol we're going to use for the negation. So this, you would read it as not P implies not Q.